Hey, I'm Winter.
I'm Ken.
And today we're going to be talking about how to interview and hire a leader, right?
That's the goal.
Okay, so tell me, is interviewing a leader on a team different from a regular employee? And if so, how?
Absolutely. I mean, when you're hiring a leader on their team, there's lots of different aspects that they are responsible for that tie around human capital, driving the business forward and things of that nature versus just task execution, which I call a lot of ground level troops or are focused on, such as a salesperson, a customer service rep or something like that. With those folks, you're trying to get insights into where their career is going, where it's been, how they execute against task, how reliable they are. But interviewing a leader is night and day.
So then when you're interviewing a leader, what specifically do you focus on?
Well, here's what I do. All right. So there's a general group of areas that I will focus on. But the first thing I will do is I'll look at the job description and I'll look at the role. Okay. Then I'll look at any previous notes that I might have and I'll jot down any red flags. But then I'll break it down. Let's say that we're hiring I was just speaking to a guy that's interviewing for a CFO role. All right, let's say we're hiring a CFO, right? What is critical for that CFO? Well, you need somebody that knows how to communicate up, communicate down, and communicate across the organization. So I'll dig into that. How do you share information? How do you drive consensus? How do you build consensus? How do you motivate your team and things of that nature? I'll also dig into human capital aspects. This is taken aside that they have the capability to actually do the job itself. But human capital, so what does human capital mean, right? What is your hiring process? Anyone in a leadership position should have a hiring process and be able to rattle that off as a no-brainer. What is your firing process? Now, I'm asking this specifically because I want to see, are they comfortable terminating people? Do they have experience in it? And have they ever done it? I always ask that question first before I ask the next question. How do you mentor people up, right? Sometimes it's easy for people to fire. Sometimes it's hard for people to fire. You also have to know how to coach and turn people around as well. So you want to gain insights into that. Another area that I will always dig into is, how do you have a gauge on where the company is going? What are some things that you put in place to give you a general direction, right? Everybody's going to talk about, I put a scorecard together or something like that. I will dig into that further and ask, what do you have on the scorecard? Did you create that? How did you come up with that? And what sort of, are they leading indicators or lagging indicators? When you actually put that scorecard together, what sort of insights did you gain in the company? What did others gain? What sort of impact did that have? So it's all about actually drilling into the areas that they are responsible for. And some of those core areas, I didn't list all, human capital, communication, holding people accountable, and running the company or the finance department.
So it sounds like you're really deep diving into their leadership skills.
Yes, correct.
And I've noticed that there's a lot of leaders out there. They can talk a great game.
Yes.
They wear the right outfit.
Yep.
They've got their power suit on.
Yep.
And they look like they fit the part.
Yeah.
So how do you really get down to the truth? Or what warning signs do you see when you're trying to find out if they really are a leader for this position?
Yeah, well, I'll be honest with you. A lot of the things that you just listed are sometimes red flags for me. There's a great book that I read when I was in an MBA class. It's called Hire With Your Head and Not Your Heart. And it actually teaches you that A-level managers can hire A-level talent. B and C-level managers hire B and C-level talent, and they cannot attract A-level. All right, now why is that? Because the people that you just articulated, they're trying to dazzle you with their look, their great hair, their suit, their perfect resume, and their shiny shoes, right? A lot of B and C-level managers fall for that immediately. The guy dressed the part. He looked great. I could go drink a beer with him. But can he run my business? Can he execute? Can he get things done? So some examples on how to get deeper. One question that I will ask a CFO or a COO specifically is, talk to me about a key initiative in a business that you ran, right? You were responsible for, how you drove consensus across the organization, and what sort of change took place? A lot of people will answer, well, you know, I was responsible for rolling out Salesforce.com, and it was great because it saved us $100,000. Great. Most people will stop right there. All right, so tell me, it saved you $100,000. What did it actually cost, right? Well, the license was 32. Great, what was the total cost of that, right? What resources did you have to use within the organization? Well, I had to use this guy, this girl, this guy, and this girl. Great, how did you make sure that the implementation was running smoothly? How did you guide the project and run the project? How did you check in? How did you make sure that they were accountable? When you were all done, how did you know it was successful? During the part of the project, did it ever get sideways? When it went sideways, what did you do, right? So you have to keep, I call it de-skinning people. It's the best way to put it. I know that sounds bad, but I'm literally taking every piece of the onion or their skin and peeling it back until they can't answer anymore. And I'm either going to get to the truth or they're going to fail because they just don't know. They can't articulate, resources. I use Jim, the IT guy. I know it takes more than that. They can't articulate what their consensus driving strategy was. They cannot articulate what the big win was for the business. So you have to actually, if you're in a senior executive interview, if you get through five questions, but get through those questions very deep, that's success. Don't shoot for more questions. Shoot for, 3 to 5 questions and go very deep.
Gotcha. Okay. We're going to wrap this up. Okay. And I want to finalize this with, what is the number one mistake in your experience that people make when interviewing and hiring a leader?
Ooh, number one mistake. I actually just wrote an email about this and I listed three. So
give us the top three.
All right. So the top three is people are desperate and want the role filled immediately. So you sell them yourself on why this candidate is great. I need a CFO. I'm tired of doing my own books. This person doesn't meet all the skill sets. I got a couple flags. I'm just going to roll the dice. First of all, that's extremely expensive, right? You're going to lose money. It's a huge lost cost opportunity there. The second thing is people don't go deep, just as I articulated, right? You stay very, very surface level, right? So, that's another thing. The third thing is the interviews are just not methodically planned, and that drives me batty. So what I mean by that is you're going through an interview and an executive, have a very defined process, right? Do not ask the candidate the same question twice, right? Make sure that in the phone screen, they ask certain questions. The next person asks certain questions. Make sure that information is shared all across the supply chain. So in the second interview, if there's a red flag, I have questions on their ability to execute, make sure that is passed forward so that the next people can actually dig into execution. The thing that a lot of people do is they'll continue asking the same darn questions over and over 3 or 4 times, right? And they think it's thorough. They will ask the question, tell me about you. The next person, tell me about you. The next person, tell me about you. It not only does it not get you deep in the candidate to find out if they're the right executive for your team, but it also makes you look bad because things are not planned out well. And if you look bad, you're not going to be able to attract the right talent. So apologize, it took a little long, but I would say those three. Stick to that and you'll do well.
That's great. Thanks so much.
Thank you.